The world is full of strange beliefs and religions. Some of them seem out there. This episode of High Five, we're going to cover 10 very strange religions we think you'll be shocked by. The slogan of the Church of Euthanasia goes like this: save the planet, kill yourself. As for their main goal, it's to create a balance between the human population and the Earth's well-being. They are well known for their conflicts with pro-life Christian activists. One of their commandments is, thou shalt not procreate, and the four pillars of the church are suicide, abortion, cannibalism, and sodomy. The College of Integrated Philosophy was created by John D. Reuter, who calls himself the living, breathing Holy Spirit, and organizes gatherings during which can last up to 3 hours, and he just sits and almost without blinking in silence. As he puts it, it's his way of understanding the depth of reality. His followers believe he has superhuman abilities, like his ability to read the dreams of people and be able to tell them who they really are and what they need in life. Realism is a religion in which people believe in an advanced extraterrestrial civilization called Elohimi that can be contacted with the use of specialized spiritual training. Realism was created in 1974 by Claude Vorlihan after aliens came to him and told him about themselves and that the Earth was created by them. In 2002, realists claimed that they had cloned the first human being and that they were going to get ready to clone Hitler so that he could stand trial for his crimes, which is utterly ridiculous. The Prince Philip movement is a religious sect followed by the Kastam people from around the Yaunin village on the southern island of Tanna in Vanuatu. It's a cargo cult of the Yaunin tribe, who believe that Prince Philip, Duke of Edinburgh, the consort to Queen Elizabeth II, is a divine being. The cult began somewhere between 1950 and 1960, and their faith only grew stronger when in 1974, the royal family planned an official visit to Vanuatu, and the village people were able to see him from afar. That's when the prince first learned about the cult, met their leaders, and exchanged presents with them. The Nation of Yahweh is a predominantly African-American group that is the most controversial offshoot of the Black Hebrew Israelites religious movement. They follow the teachings of Judaism and identify themselves as Jewish. It has often been labeled a hate group and was founded in 1979 in Miami by Holland Mitchell Jr., who went by the name Yahweh Ben Yahweh. Its goal is to move African-Americans, whom they see as the original Israelites, back to Israel. The SPLC has criticized the beliefs of the Nation of Yahweh as racist, stating that the group believed that blacks are the true Israelites and that whites were devils. The Missionary Church of Copimism is a congregation of file sharers who believe that copying information is a sacred virtue, and those who hold copyrights, devils. The church based in Sweden has officially been recognized as a religion. Now, this may come in handy if during a court hearing, a person is being sued for copyright violations. He or she may say that due to their faith and religion, they are obliged to copyright and perhaps could file for religious intolerance. This cult has been in existence for 80 years now in Papua New Guinea. Its followers believe that white people remove the first few pages of the Bible's New Testament that state that Jesus Christ was Papuan. The followers believe that one day he will return and make all Papuans gods and all white people their slaves. In the jungles of Brazil, there exists a tribe of people called the Tipiri that consider parasites to be holy. They believe that spirits that had created this world conceal themselves within the bodies of people and from within their bodies give them advice and guide them. So that means that the extraction of parasites means the eviction of holy spirits and equals automatic banishment from the clan. When the Second World War was going on, American soldiers hopped from one oceanic island to another, carrying with them various goods and parcels. The native people of the islands liked the Americans' cargo so much that they began worshipping it and considering it a gift from the gods, as times it would fall from the heavens on parachutes. This religion has up to 5 million followers in India. Their main principles are based on the belief that causing harm to any animals is unholy, and so it's forbidden for them to ever take up arms, and they also do not eat meat. Amongst them are holy beings called Shvetimbari, or those clothed in light, and they don't believe in wearing clothes. So as not to kill so much as an insect, they wear a face mask and sweep up the rope from behind them with a special broom. They also believe that dying of hunger is the holy and godly way to pass on to the other side. And that's been it for this episode of High Five. We'd love for you to join our cult, but first you need to high five that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.